Mary.
Listen, my name is Roy D. Mercer. I called. I had a problem at one of y'all's lumber yards that y'all insure.
Yes.
And they told me to call y'all. I was down there and bought a bunch of assorted nuts and bolts, a package of them.
Mm-hmm.
And it's supposed to be one of them resealed packages. And I had it sealed up, or thought I did, and I guess it popped open because our dog, we got a long-haired poodle, Kenny G is his name, and he had a bunch of 3/8-inch nuts, I guess, near, I can figure, about a dozen or so. And the dog, he passed away yesterday.
Who'd you get them from?
Lumber store there in Collinsville.
Yeah. Okay, let me give you an 800 number. We don't handle claims out of this office.
Well, listen, I'm getting a runaround here because I got a dead dog over here. It's the poorest thing you've ever seen in your life. Every time the damn dog got urged, hit him, he'd start whimpering and whining. He knew what was coming.
Bless his heart.
Okay. Mama cries every time she sees his empty beret and sweater set she knitted for him, too.
You mean he was one of the family?
Well, by God. In fact, it was more than that, really, ma'am. He's a hometown hero. He was down there. We was eating a burger. We was down at Elton's Burger Queen.
Mm-hmm.
It was down there. Everything's flamed down there. And there's a boy that's choked on a tater tot. And old Kenny G run over there. And they started, he's kind of sniffing at his crotch a little bit there when he's down on the ground. And that boy started giggling and laughing and coughed that tot back up and saved his life.
Great.
So he's kind of hometown hero, and what I was hoping to do was to get y'all to give me some money that we could erect a monument for him.
Well, I'm not the one you want to talk to. Like I said, let me give you...
Well, I done talked to a couple of people, and they said that concrete statue, we could do one of two things. Maybe get him have a concrete statue, or maybe one of them chain... I was thinking more like one of them chainsaw sculptures. So, and they said they could do either one we wanted, but it's $400 for the concrete or $650 for the chainsawed stump.
Well, like I said, I'm not the one you want to talk to, but let me give you a phone number and a name.
Because he bound up on the ship. We thought he was going to be all right, and I guess he must have tried to pass a lock washer or something because he bound up.
Okay, try 1-800.
Yeah.
Just a minute. Let me look.
Listen, there ain't no way I could come down there to y'all's office and get $400 or $650.
Oh, heavens, no. What? I'm just a small service office.
Well, what am I supposed to tell my family?
Well, now, Mr. Mercer, I don't know, babe.
Well,
I'm trying to give you a phone number, though, that you can call that perhaps they can tell you yay or nay.
Yeah. My boy, he tried mineral oil. He tried glycerin suppositories, and I guess that must have got cross-threaded down there.
Bless his heart. All right.
And I'm afraid if I don't get some satisfaction out of this, I might be moved to come down and whoop somebody's ass over this.
Have you talked to the management?
They gave me your number and told me to call down here to the insurance company. They said they just washed their hands of the whole thing. And they told me to call y'all.
Well, like I said, I don't have anything to do with claims here.
Well, I tell you what, now.
All right, 1-800.
We had a nice couple here in town. Stephen and Deborah Adams promised us to their next puppy.
Stephen and Debbie Adams. I have a son and a daughter-in-law by the name of Stephen and Debbie Adams.
Do they raise famous life-saving dogs?
No.
They don't do that?
No.
Do they put people up to playing jokes on folks?
Mary Lou, you bought that whole story, didn't you?
Who is this?
This is Phil and Brent and Roy D. Mercer from Tulsa.
Who put you up to this?
Well, I believe it was your son and daughter-in-law.
I'm going to kill those kids.
Not before they have them puppies.
I don't give a shit about them puppies. I could care less about his friggin' old dog.